juice. Just might have to get this. What's good, guys? Happy Friday. Downstairs in the dungeon right now. Need to get this box. Well, I don't really need to get it, but I just want to show you guys. Wow. From my good old dumpster diving days, GameStop dumpster diving. Man, it's been like 2 years, a little over 2 years since I've gone dumpster diving. But I went through a box of games and controllers and stuff like that from their Field Destroy stuff. But it's like a ton of it is like still good. And then, of course, all the really good games that you would have wanted to have kept if you went dumpster diving. Yeah, like Damage and stuff. But look at this box. So, pretty big box. Stuffed all the way around with tons of everyone's favorite Kinect Adventures for the Xbox 360. Pretty much if you have gone dumpster diving before, GameStop dumpster diving, or if you still go, you at one point in time came across tons of these games, like me, tons of these freaking PS3 Sports Champions games, and nothing's wrong with these. I got a ton more MLB The Show, a bunch of Madden 2009, 2010, 2011. As you can see in there, and box like a bunch of Guitar Hero World Tour, Legends of Rock. So this whole box, when I went through, I separated everything that was good, not damaged, not cut, nothing. And yeah, I have an entire box of games, a few of these UMDs, Open Season. I think there's like a game back in here for like your PSP or whatnot. And then this box and this right here, a bunch of controllers, wires, everything in great condition, you know, not cut, damaged, broken. Wii U controller, this mini Xbox 360 controller. So basically like a ton of stuff. I went through that because need to walk back here more. I wanted to take a few games to that Game Grid place since I got like a ton. Not a lot, not all of them obviously, because they're a bunch of them are the same, but I got a good little stack because I still have like $6 or $10 store credit. So that's where I am going to go in a few minutes. But let me show you, I'm in the back closet area, which is a mess. But there's a box here, if I can find it. Hang on just a second. Alright, so lighting is really bad because it's like one of the back rooms downstairs here in the basement, the dungeon. But these are just cases. Well, I can't see that. But these are cases that had like games that were all damaged. These are the discs. Hold on, let me try and move it into the light. That's a little bit better. So yeah, a bunch of cases I decided to keep just in case I do something with these games, like take them over, get them resurfaced, or even buy a resurfacing machine for myself. But like a ton of games, like God of War. They went to town on that. That one actually doesn't look too deep. But like a bunch of games, GameStop just destroyed. You know, they could have sold on the cheap for like a sale or something like that. And yeah, so these were the games that did not survive, you know. I'll take a look at that later. But now, let's go to Game Grid. All right, so just waiting on my wife and son. They're going to hit up the dollar store while I go to Game Grid. And this is a little stack of games that I will be taking over to add on to what I already have. So here they come. Let's go. Strawberries in a can. Only at the dollar store. Looks like they're having a freaking clearance sale over here at Tags. Just left the freaking all of Utah's in there. Typical for a Saturday morning or afternoon or Saturday in general. But I did not find anything. Well, I bought two things, but gaming wise, they had like this Ziploc, well, a few Ziploc bags with like DS games. I think prices might have been like $25 to like $40 or something like that. A ton of games. They had four Super Nintendo games in a Ziploc bag, kind of like what I bought in my last video for like $45, but this one they had for $50. One of the games that was in that little pack of four was a game called Lemmings or something like that. I've never played it before. The game that was like facing upwards right below it, the label's all messed up, so I couldn't see what it was. And then of course couldn't see what the other two games behind them were because they were facing down. And then they had like what was left over of like six, I think, N64 games for like, I think they might have had that price at like $45. Some girl, I think it might have been yesterday or the day before, she fell for this dude bought one game out of the pack instead of just buying the whole thing. Because supposedly you're supposed to buy the whole thing unless you can trick someone into selling you one. Because a lot of times they won't budge even if you tell them, well, this game is only worth this much, and you show them. This dude told this girl that worked there, I think it might have been like N64 Mario Party 3 or something like that. Now, I don't know if this is correct. I mean, it may be. But she sold it to him, like, just the one game for $25, the N64 Mario Party 3. And he told her it was only worth, like, $20-$25. And that, or no, he said $25-$30, and then he'll pay $25. And she's like, oh, okay. So she let him buy just that one game. But the rest of them are gone, as well as that bag of Super Nintendo games, which was, like, $50. Other than that, nothing much new as far as like all those DS games, but hopefully Tags has something. I mean, they got this freaking clearance sale. I believe they do veterans discounts, so not sure if I can even use that since they have like they're having a clearance sale, but we'll see. Hopefully there's something in here. Let's go check, and hopefully not all of Utah is here. It doesn't look like it. Let's go. Got some crazy ass weather going on. I think it's about to rain. And we need it. It's hot as freaking balls out here. I found a miracle piano. Didn't find a damn thing. Alright, so since that didn't work out, I am and I can't speak. I am here now, just pulled up to one of my favorite spots to get some food. It's called Sushi Burrito Number 5. But I don't come for the sushi burrito. This is like my third or fourth time coming here for their pho. And if you don't know what pho is, it's like that Vietnamese, I believe Vietnamese, maybe not, but it's like soup with like a bunch of like meats and vegetables and awesomeness. That's what I'm here for. At least I know I can find that here. And it's really not expensive, like $9. I get like, that's like the biggest one that they have. So it's right behind me. Nice pho. Some people call it pho, but I think they said it's pronounced pho. So yeah, let's go get some pho soup. Alright guys, so I'm back home, ready to eat this delicious pho. See it? What the fuh? But there will be more thrifting later on and throughout the week, so hopefully you stay tuned for part 2. My ass is hungry, so I'm going to go inside and eat. And kind of crazy outside as normal, or as usual rather, with the thrift stores. Well, I only went to one, but Tags sucks ass. But at least there's always pho. What the pho? And holy pho, I think it's about to rain, finally. Hopefully. And pho, all this not finding too much stuff at the thrift stores. Fuh me. Fuh. Almost spilled it. It's all good. See you guys in the next one. Part 2. Bye. We'll be right back.